I've been coming down to Belize for almost 20 years, and shortly after I came to Belize on my first trip, I became aware that there were no prosthetic and orthotic services available to anybody in the entire country.
It opened my eyes when we came down here at how much the United States does have compared to other countries.
This is Adrian Camara. He's the clinical manager of Project Hope Belize. He was born without legs. Adrian does not wear prosthetic legs. It hinders him on a day-to-day basis.
This is my working space right here, which is why you see all these benches low on the ground. Well, of course, I'm pretty low on the ground.
I think what makes Project Hope Belize unique is that it's not a one-stop shop. We just didn't come in, deliver a bunch of products and leave.
About half the patients we see are from vascular disease, and half the patients that receive a prosthesis are from trauma.
This is Sierra. Sierra has cerebral palsy. When she walks up on her toes, and she has a crouch gait, which means her knees are bent when she walks, and her feet scissor across each other. So the goal for her is when she's walking, to get her heels down on the ground and get her knees back into a more neutral position so that she's not so crouched down. With the long-term hope that she can get around on her own and not have to rely on her mom to carry her around.
This is where Sierra lives. She lives in a little compound with her mom's brothers and sisters. This is Mr. Toon, and he lost his leg about 5 years ago, and he hasn't stood or had a leg at all, so he has a contracture. You can see his knee is bent. Because of the lack of healthcare follow-up, problems occur.
He lost half of his foot.
He's diabetic.
He said with this leg, they cut off some of his toes, and he said that that's what they should have done with this other leg. They didn't do that, so he's kind of upset about that.
Feel good, because man, that guy's not sitting in his wheelchair at home dying because he can't get a leg.
I have fallen in love with Belize.
It has been a constant struggle to try and keep the clinic afloat.
Raw products, raw materials that we need to make the braces and the prostheses, but the money is very critical for the continuation of Project Hope Belize.
We need help here in Belize, definitely.
Everything down here costs more than you would expect it would just for the basic sustenance of the people and certainly for our clinic.
If it wasn't for you guys, we wouldn't be able to get most of the attention our children with special needs have.
If I need to plead with people to open their wallets and to provide us with what we need to keep everything going, I'll do that.
Back when I was a kid, I always asked myself why I was born this way. Because even if I would go to an activity, I couldn't get in because I was way down in the floor, and I, you know, everybody would step on me, and you know. So it was painful, yeah. But yet, I didn't give up, and it makes me feel good. I'm very grateful. And I hope I can do it until the day I die. I hope.
Stop with the violence, down with the hate. One day we'll all be free and proud to be under.
please visit prosthetichope.org and help now.